I'm Shalini B, working as Assistant Professor of Physics. I'm going to discuss the topic for BSc 5th semester, paper 5.2, session 8. The topic of the session 8 is Concept of de Broglie's matter waves. Before going to discuss this topic, we have to know what is a wave, a particle, and dual nature of radiation. So then what is a wave and a particle? If you consider a particle, it has mass, it is located at some definite point, and it can move from one place to another. And it is specified by mass, velocity, momentum, and energy. But whereas a wave, it spreads out over a relatively large region of space, it cannot be located at one particular point. So it is specified by its frequency, wavelength, phase velocity, amplitude, and intensity. Then knowing wave and a particle, then what is the duality of radiation? So a radiation, it has a dual nature, that is, it behaves as a wave as well as a particle. So the, for example, if we consider the phenomena of interference, diffraction, and polarization, in while constantly dealing with these phenomena, interference, diffraction, polarization, radiation is considered as behaving like a wave. But whereas the phenomena like photoelectric effect, Compton effect, and the energy spectrum of black body radiation, they can be explained by considering a particle nature of light. So thus the radiation, it has both wave nature as well as a particle nature. That is, it sometimes behaves as a wave and at other time it behaves as a particle. So that is, radiation has a wave-particle duality. But both the nature of radiation cannot be exhibited simultaneously. That is, radiation cannot exhibit its particle and wave properties simultaneously. Knowing all this one, then what is the de Broglie's hypothesis of matter waves? By the end of the 19th century, it was considered that the energy is something different from a matter. Energy was propagated in the form of a wave, while the matter was essentially discontinuous. The phenomena like diffraction, then interference, and polarization can be explained by considering the wave nature of light, whereas the properties like Compton effect and the photoelectric effect can be explained by considering the particle nature of light. Thus, the light behaves as a dual nature. So, it possesses both particle nature and a wave properties. So, then Louis de Broglie in 1924, he extended the wave-particle duality of light to all the fundamental entities of physics, such as electrons, protons, neutrons, atoms, and molecules, etc. So, like radiation, matter also has a dual characteristics. That means matter also behaves like a particle nature as well as a wave nature. So, according to de Broglie, a moving particle, it is associated with the wave, and that particle which is associated with the wave is known as a de Broglie matter wave or a de Broglie wave, and the wavelength of the de Broglie matter wave is given by h by p, where p is a momentum, or the wavelength of the matter wave lambda is equal to h by mv. Where h, in this equation, h is a Planck's constant and m is the mass of the particle and v its velocity and p is the momentum. So this is the de Broglie's hypothesis of matter wave. That is, a full wave, a particle is associated with the wave, which is known as a de Broglie matter wave, which is having a wavelength given by lambda is equal to h by mv. So all these materials I have collected from the books Unified Physics Volume 4, College Physics Volume 3, and Modern Physics by Murugesan. Thank you.